up to rupees 64, and that 64 rupees is given by Y Bank as loan. Then in this way, the total deposits created by the banking system as a whole is referred as the credit creation. For example, 100 rupees was deposited with X Bank as PD, primary deposit. Then Y, in fact, that X Bank gave 80 rupees loan. Then borrower of that 80 rupees, he deposits with Y Bank. Then Y Bank will have 20% and it has a capacity to lend loan up to 64. So this process continues n number of times. A simple formula is used in order to determine total credit created by the banking system as a whole. Thus, the formula to calculate this credit creation is: credit creation is equal to primary deposits by CRR. Multiple credit creation by commercial banks can be clearly understood with the help of the following table. In our previous example, for the sake of simplicity, primary deposits we have assumed to be rupees 100. But in this example, we assume primary deposits as rupees 1000 in bank A. Then same old CRR 20% they are supposed to have in the form of cash. Having 200, then bank A can lend up to 800 rupees. Then the borrower of this 800 rupees makes payment to somebody else. That goes to bank B as primary deposit. Out of 800, then B bank can lend up to rupees 160, because even there's a mandatory rule for B bank to have 20% of 800 in the form of CRR. Then B bank can give loan up to 640, and this process continues n number of times. Credit multiplier. The amount of total deposits created by the banking system as a whole as a multiple of the initial increase in the primary deposit is called credit multiplier. It's a very important question that you can expect for 2 marks. I repeat once again, the amount of total deposits created by the banking system as a whole as a multiple of the initial increase in the primary deposit is called credit multiplier. If the primary deposit increases by rupees 100, the total deposits created by all the commercial banks together is 500, then credit multiplier is equal to 500 by 100, then 5 is credit multiplier. Banks create money collectively. Supposing, assume there's only one bank, bank A. Then A bank gets a primary deposit of rupees 100. It'll have the CRR of rupees 20 and lends 80 to somebody else. Then that person also deposits the same 80 to the bank A. Then credit creation is not possible. The amount is circulated within the bank. That is why we say banks create money or credit collectively. That's why we say banking system as a whole. However, from the above discussion, it is very clear that banks create deposits collectively. No one bank can create money on its own. Limitations of credit creation. In fact, there are so many limitations on credit creation. The very first one, lack of banking habits. That is, if person A borrows the loan of rupees 80 from a commercial bank, then that rupees 80 is made as payment to somebody else. Suppose, assume that somebody else is B. B is not having the banking account, bank account only. In that case, it will not go to the bank and the process of credit creation gets disturbed. If an individual prefers to hold the money in the form of cash, this process of credit creation gets affected. Second, higher CRR, cash is a ratio. In our example, we assumed CRR to be 20%. Suppose if it is 40%, the capacity of the banks to lend loan decreases. 3. Inadequate collateral securities. Remember, no bank can give loan without collateral security or mortgage. But remember, if individuals don't have the collateral securities, then they cannot borrow. Economic depression. If the condition in the economy is such that unemployment is more, their ability to pay loans is quite less, then they cannot get loans. When they cannot get loans, credit creation gets disturbed. However, a point to be noted, meaning of the word credit creation. Again, in a simplest way, you can write like this. Credit creation is the expansion of deposits where the banks expand their demand deposits as a multiple of their cash reserves. Thank you.